we will see how to check this laptop motherboard. Already I have given these lessons in our regional language Telugu, but so many people wants in English. I don't know fluency of English. I will give with my best in this lesson. Any language mistakes, forgive me. First, you should download this laptop motherboard circuit. These circuits available in forshed.com or lqv77.com. Now I will download this circuit. This is DV2000 V3000 motherboard. See here, lqv77.com. Now HP Pavilion DV2000 Compact V3000 schematic circuit diagram. This is this laptop motherboard circuit diagram. I will explain with circuit diagram this motherboard, how to check dead laptop motherboard. I will explain with this, the help of this circuit diagram. Every laptop motherboard has three types of voltages. Those are always voltage ALW or auxiliary voltage or AL voltage. That means always, this is 12 volts DC, 5 volts DC, 3.3 volts DC. This voltage will present without pressing power button. This voltage comes from DC adapter or battery. These two voltages come out from 5 volts and 3.3 volts regulator IC. Suspend voltage S5, S3, S4 states. This is suspend voltage 5 volts, 3.3 volts and memory supply. If in that motherboard used in DDR1, that voltage 2.5 volts, DDR2 1.8 volts, DDR3 1.5 volts. Run power S0 state. Power on voltages ICH supply, SIO supply, GMCH supply, graphics supply, CPU supply, other supplies. Now we will see first this always supply. This is DC jack. This is battery connector. Every laptop motherboard have this 5 volts and 3.3 volts regulator IC. But number is different from this. When you connect adapter to this DC jack, this voltage 14 to 18 volts, this voltage comes to this IC, 5 volts and 3.3 volts regulator IC, through two FETs. This is battery connector. From battery connector, when you connect battery, from battery connector 12 volts come out from battery connector to 5 volts and 3.3 volts regulator IC through this FET. If it is faulty, motherboard cannot work with DC adapter, but this will work with battery. Motherboard will work with battery. If it is faulty, motherboard will work with DC adapter, but will not, the motherboard will not work with battery. So if it is faulty, motherboard cannot work with DC jack or battery. So if any laptop motherboard is dead, you should check from DC jack to 5 volts and 3.3 volts regulator IC. From these DC jacks to 14 to 18 volts comes to this IC and another pin shut down. When you give voltage to input pin and shut down pin, the 5 volts and 3.3 volts will present at LDO5, means low dropout 5 volts, low dropout 3.3 volts, 3 means will present here. Two voltages will present here. We will see in circuit. This is circuit. This is laptop motherboard. See here. System DC TPS 51120 inputs DC bat out. That means DC adapter. Bat means battery out. That means 18 volts DC adapter. If you have given voltage from adapter, this voltage 18 volts. If you connect battery, this voltage 12 volts. So input voltage 12 volts or 18 volts. Output volts 5 volts S3 state, 3 volts S5 state. So we will see that page. This is DC in 1 jack. This is adapter jack. This is DC in adapter jack. Pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pin number 2, 3, ground, 4, 5 voltage. Pin number 1, 2, 3, ground, 4, 5 supply pins. This supply, when you connect adapter to these pins, this positive voltage come out from these pins to this track. This to U58, 1, 2, 3 pins. This is input pins. When you give voltage, when you give 5 volts to this gate, that means pin number 4, voltage, the output voltage will present, at 5, pin number 5, 6, 7, 8. No voltage at this point, pin number 4, this voltage will not present here. This is adapter plus. This is adapter off. This is adapter off. Q18. When motherboard is short, this adapter off voltage, 3 volts comes to this pin. Pin number 2, Q18. When this voltage will present here, this voltage goes to 14 volts. When this voltage goes to 14 volts, this output voltage will not present. When this voltage will, then this voltage is 5 volts, this voltage will present here. So, input voltage is okay. No output at this point, you should check these two transistors. If DC jack is short, you should check C460, EC48, EC10 and C459. The four components you should check these capacitors. We will see U58. Pin number 1. This is pin number 1, 2, 3, 4. Pin number 5, 6, 7, 8. This is U58. Q18. This is Q18. C460, C459. If DC jack is short, you should check these capacitors. Adapter plus. This voltage goes to charger page. Charger IC page. So total pages 47. This is 39th page. See here, 39 of 47. Charger max 8725. This is IC, charger IC. This is adapter path. This is battery path. So this is adapter. Adapter voltage comes to this FET. This is adapter plus. This voltage comes from page number 46. This voltage comes to U4, pin number 5, 6, 7, 8. When you give voltage to pin number 4, this input voltage comes out from this pin number 1, 2, 3. This is output pins, this is input pins. This is input pins, this is output pins. This is gate. When you give voltage to gate, this voltage from comes from this pins to this pin. These pins. This is pin number 1, 2, 3. Pin number 1, 2, 3. R45. This is current limiting resistor. G5, G6. This is gap resistor. G5, G6. This is gap resistors. DC bat out. See here. This is battery connector. This voltage comes from battery connector. This voltage comes from battery connector. We will see. See here, page number 46. Battery connector. This is battery connector. From this battery connector, voltage come out from BT plus. This is battery positive pin. This voltage goes to from battery connector to positive voltage comes to this FET U5, pin number 5, 6, 7, 8, U5, this is U5, pin number 5, 6, 7, 8, this is input, this is output, this is output, this is BAT, DC BAT out, that means DC adapter, battery out, this is combined voltage. So U4, this is U4, this is U5, this is U4, this is U5. Adapter voltage comes to this chip, this is input pin, this is output pin. Battery voltage comes to this FET, this is input pins, this is output pins. These two voltages comes to this resistor. See here, this voltage comes to this IC, this is the combined path, this is combined path. You should check here 12 volts DC is there or not. If you connect adapter, you should check 18 volts is there or not. So this voltage goes to 5 volts and 3.3 volts regulator IC. This is 5 volts and 3.3 volts regulator IC circuit, page number 36. This is U44 IC. You see, this is U44 IC. When you give voltage to Vin pin number 22, when you give voltage to input pin number 22, this voltage 5 volts, V regulator 5 volts. The 5 volts comes out from this pin, pin number 21. You should check voltage at this point, C383, 382. So this is C382. You should check here 5 volts is there or not. If 5 volt will present here, this IC is okay. Next, V regulator 3.3 volts. You should check at this capacitor C385. You should check here voltage is there or not. 3.3 volts is there or not. So this is 3.3 volts capacitor, this is 5 volts capacitor. You should check here. The 3.3 volts goes to SIO chip and BIOS chip, will present without pressing power button. I will give this type online classes also. If you have any laptop motherboard, I will give this type coaching in online. If you want demo classes, I will give 2 demo classes. After, you should satisfaction with that classes, you should pay amount.